Yeah, welcome everyone. Thanks for tuning in. Glad that you're here and be ready for some live coding. And first of all, my name is Ko Turk, working for Bluefire IT, small consultancy company. A small warning. Yeah, this meeting will contain live coding, so everything could potentially go wrong, but yeah, we trained it, but yeah, you never know, right? So yeah, what you will learn, how to create a payment application with Apache Kafka Streams and Actuator. And some disclaimer, we have some images, scary or not, so be aware. The story. Imagine that you were a developer back in the 90s. So more than 20, maybe 30 years ago, you were a developer. And you need to write something let what looks like a microservice or something. So yeah, that was a little bit a nightmare. Running applications on different machines. People had trouble with that, especially have different hardware and programmers or developers were creating their own software themselves and writing to sockets the whole protocol stack. So that was it was hard, but yeah, we've been into another stage. So let's go on. After the 90s or the late 90s, 1998, there was Korba, a kind of ghost house. You need to talk to other services, and yeah, I'm glad we have something. So in a nutshell, it is sending messages to a broker, and it's sending. It's a kind of proxy, but you can imagine that was expensive because you have a man in the middle, and you need a contract, and that contract on both sides you need to agree, and if you have a different organization like back days. It was really a trouble. And then you had SOAP, much better already, but still that contract. Nowadays you also have contracts, right? But you don't need a whistle and that kind of things. It was easier, but it was more strict. It's XML, so it was less complex. And we needed something like JSON. So then we go for REST in the 2000, the beginning of the zeros. Roy Fielding founded REST when he had his PhD. And difference, SOAP is a protocol, REST is more like an architecture. It's based on HTTP, GET based, put POST, and you know it already, right? But it was really easy. And nowadays, everyone is almost using the REST standard. And that's perfect, right? But it's sometimes a little bit slow, especially if you're talking about big data. We want something asynchronous. So let's go asynchronous. It's possible also to do it with HTTP and that kind of things, but HTTP isn't designed to go asynchronous. So let's go with Apache Kafka. I will help you with setting up your project and that kind of things. So let's go. My talk, event streaming applications with Kafka Streams, Spring Kafka, and Actuator. So it will contain some live coding, so please hold on some beginnings. A short introduction. My name is Ko Turk. Please leave me a tweet. I will be really delighted if you can do that. I'm working at the Rabobank for a small consultancy company called Bluefire IT. A member of the Utrecht Jerk. I'm talking also about Macrometer and Kotlin. And I'm married, that kind of things. I like trail biking. But now back to you. What are the key takeaways of this talk? We are going to easily set up a cluster, a Kafka cluster. We are going to set up a consumer and a producer. And we are going to set up a streams application with proper monitoring with Apache Kafka. But first, almost there, hang on. for the live coding. Why do we want something like Kafka? You have different styles. You have different styles of communication. You can see time-based. Something is happening on 12 o'clock. Something scary is coming up. That's time-based. If you talk about communication, you have also something like request-driven, like the REST architecture. You can see it like a painting, and you're going to the museum, and you want to see a painting. And after the next painting, you walk to the next one, and there you see another painting. And so that's request-based, what I want. But something else can also pop up, like a spider is crawling, and you need to do something. And even there are more spiders, and they're all events. Oh no, what should I do? And that's more like event-based, like I need to try to catch all those spiders and or someone else, if you're afraid of spiders. But that's more like event-based. So we want something for the spiders. We want something fast. We want something that is asynchronous. We want something that is less complex, like we want to program functional. We want to program in streaming. We want to have something that is fault tolerant. You don't want, for example, in a banking environment, you don't want that payments are lost. That's really horrible if that is happening. So we need something that is fault tolerant. like this. If something is bleeding, then you want to know, recover fast. And if that is happening, if you have an exception that can occur, right? Something, your application is broken, then you want to have the possibility to replay it again. You can see it like a motorcycle, and you can took back all those messages if you want. Like it's my system is crashing and I want to reprocess from a certain number. And that is very, very handy when you're using Kafka. And that's also a big difference with publish subscribe, like MQ or RabbitMQ. You can use that also, but mostly it doesn't have this functionality, or as it has, that mostly like Google Cloud is expensive. Yeah, so there are a big difference in that. Not about the differences. So if you have questions about that, please contact me later. What I said, we have Kafka. We want something that is fault tolerant. We want something that is very fast, asynchronous. The replayability, functionality, and that kind of things. And there are three flavors here. You have the Kafka Connect, so you can connect your database. You can also send a message to a kind of with the producer, and someone else is consuming it. So this is the basic. And on top of that, you have Kafka Streams. It's also consisting about a DSL where you can program functionally, and that's a layer above where you can handle messages in a streaming way. So here coming the key takeaways. What do you need? A cluster like this one from Kafka. Just go to this URL and you'll see an easy setup. And you can create your own cluster on your local environment or on your server even. But you need to manage it yourself. That can be hard. It isn't hard, but it can be. So you have also cloud vendors, but for more about that later. So what I said, you have platform vendors. One famous big play is Confluent. So if you don't want to maintain your Kafka cluster, go to a Confluent or go to an Actual. It's a Dutch company. And then you don't have the complexity for creating topics. Like in your own environment, you need to create topics. And then you have a shell. And a shell you can execute, and then it's creating a topic for you. In my project, I will share it also on my GitHub. I have some possibilities to create the topics on your own environment if you want. So, are you ready for some live coding? And by the way, if you have some questions, please let me know through the chat or something. That will be nice. I will also check if there are chats in the chat. And otherwise, Andrea, please let me know. So, what I said, I already started an own server with Docker. I did this, not with the default way, which you saw. I did it like here. I have a Docker instance and a YAML. And in its YAML, it's a YAML. And there's a Docker image that's containing about Zookeeper. It's more like an overall to check your servers. Are they up or down? We need Kafka. We need something that's called a schema registry. In Kafka, they are talking or just plain string or integer or whatever. Or you can just have something like an object, like an Avro object. And how does that look like? In the basic, and in resources. For example, we have a payment. We have an Avro schema. So how is our Avro schema looking like? I created my own payment for it. And it looks like this. It looks a little bit like XML, JSON. And it's creating in my POM. I already created some in my POM. I have an Avro Maven plugin. And by the way, I will commit this and you can already find it in GitHub. So you can also watch it later if you want. So what it does is generating sources in the source main resources. I place something and it will generate some sources for you, some Avro messages. Is it already there? Is it? Yeah. So what it does, it's create a payment for you and an Avro. So, we have something like an Avro generated schema. For that, you need this one, this dependency, Avro. Well, latest version is not the latest version, I guess. You can use it. So that's very already powerful. Let's continue. Yeah, like everyone almost is creating REST microservices, but a lot of those complicated logic can be removed and placed somewhere else, so you can do it asynchronously. So I created a payment engine. Maybe I can better show you the image, how it looks like. So normally you have a traditional REST service without Kafka. So you do all your logic in that REST service and you need to wait some seconds or maybe longer or something, and that's not what you want. Some logic you can do asynchronously, even by another application, and which is easier to maintain. And for this purpose, you can see we have a transaction service and a transaction service or topology we're going to create, a streaming application. And that one is talking to other applications or other topics. So in Kafka, you have topics where you listen, you can produce to it, or you can consume from it. Let's go. So we have a controller here. We have a process payment. Yeah, it's just normal. Like we have a post. Of course, you can have a get, something like that. And you have something like a payment service. But first, we want to create a payment. So what are we going to do? Oh, wait, we have also a fraud. We can do it maybe later. I will also create a fraud object. And we want to just get the fraud transactions. We want to have it in a separate topic so we can read from it. So let's create a payment. I already have something here. So we are going to create a payment. Within the AFRO message, you have a builder, a new builder. And you can, in the payment, have a name, an amount, and a balance, IBAN, to IBAN, and processed, and build. So, you need to do the build, otherwise you cannot get as a builder pattern. So that's very useful and secure. And we're going to process a payment. First, I'm going to create a producer. So normally what you do is you're checking the balance, you're checking the payment, you maybe have some rewarding, you have analytics, maybe you want to send alerts, you have all kind of things. So we want to make it asynchronously. So what do we want to do? We want to send a transaction. So for that, I have again, first we need to create a Kafka template. Kafka templates. So like this. And within the Kafka template, you can say, hey, I have a key, it's a string, and I have a value, that's the payment. So I want to, from the REST server, someone has created a payment, and I want to process it, and I want to send it to a topic. And later on the topic, we want to create a topology or a streaming application. So we're going to send a transaction. So we are sending the transaction, and it's a topic payment, and that's the payment that we want to send. And we're logging it. That's the most important thing you would need to do, and creating metrics in Actuator. So don't forget that. 2.4. And we want to send that message. Like within Kafka, you have a possibility, or Spring Kafka. That is, by the way, this dependency, Spring Kafka. You have those possibilities to send the messages. So we are going to send something to a topic with a message. It's always waiting. Okay. So on this moment, we are going to send a message, a payment. And of course, you can do other things like I want to do other checks, like I want to do a balance check. I want to send something to reward the customer. And those kind of things can also being done afterwards. Like we are mostly creating REST is so many use. So you can also create a different application from it. So your own application is even quicker. And afterwards, you can cancel payment or something now, just how you want it. that's all possible. So, and the next step is then to consume it. For that, we have a payment processor. It's setting on the payment, and it's consuming. And how do you consume with Spring Kafka? You have just a listener, Kafka listener, and it's listen on topics, and you can also give it some group ID if you want. You can group topics, and it's all possible. We are receiving it. Oh, it's already there. That's nice. And we want to get it. So we want to get the consumer record that value and set the payment. We now are going to produce a message, a payment, and we want to consume it somehow. That consuming normally you do in another topic, but now I just wanted to see that's also possible to have a single message consumed like this. It's not in a streaming way yet. You have also a fraud object. We want to catch the frauds, and we also want to check the balance. Something I will show you in a later moment where we create the streaming application. We are going to create a fraud. Listener, it's first listener, otherwise it isn't listening, right? And again, we want to cast it to a fraud object. And for, it's just easy, I just save it to this object, but you can also save it to a database or whatever you want, just for demo purposes. So on this moment, we created a producer, which is sending data to a Kafka topic, and we have something that consumes from a fraud topic, a blacklist, I call this. So, let's go to the test. Stop this one, the payment controller, the payment service as shown you. I showed you the payments, the POM, Docker I shown you. So we're going to check the test. I'm going to test against our own instance locally. What are we going to do? I'm just going to test the service with processing a payment, and what it does is just going into these kind of things. So it's going to send a transaction to payment. So, what we want to do is just check if the message is there. Set a transaction with a message, and that message is processed through app. So, we are going to, it will fail because we didn't have everything, which I'm going to show you. Let's go here. We're going to test it. Let's test it. So here you can set this setting a fraud object also. Just like this, debug it. So it's not where I wanted to be. So here you see that it's first checking because we are using the await function. Also, by the way, in the POM you can check it. It's just a way to just wait for some messages because you cannot get it instantly because it needs some milliseconds. And we wait at most, 10 seconds. Okay. What do we have here? Timeout. Checking my instance. Yeah, there it is. Sometimes it has some backlog. So here we have a payment. So we now received a payment. Like what we're sending is a Mr. Bloom. We have an IBAN and a 2 IBAN. We want to send an amount of 100 euros with a balance of 500, and its process is true. So on this moment, I show you that we are producing something and it's also consumed because it's setting the payment here. So if you look to the service we created, we sent some transaction here. We did that. And I also shown you that we have the payment. So it's also here. So we have the set payment and it saves it here. And we get it from here, what I shown you. So on this moment, I also proven that you can consume a message. And then later on, it will the balance is okay, we can say, or something. And then it's going to check the fraud. But that fraud object is not there yet. So it will fail, like it should, and timeout because it's over the 10 seconds. Okay, cool. So the next step is creating a Kafka streaming application, and that's where the fun begins. I create a topology. Everything within Kafka is consisting about nodes, and some nodes make a topology. So we're creating the topology. Within the topology, we have the nodes. Like we have a node that handles the stream, like handle the payments. We have a stream that handles the frauds. So what we are going to do is we are going to create it. So with 4.1, that's the wrong one, it's not working like this. So we are going to create a stream payment. So we are creating with the streams builder. And by the way, this is a different application. What I've shown you, I'm going too fast, sorry. Because I really like the topic. So you have a POM. And within the POM, you have, of course, you have your starter, you have, web is even not needed, but is it? Maybe it is. Yeah. Spring Kafka. It is also not needed. We only need Kafka streams. We're using Lombok. You can use Kafka test and that kind of things. Kafka test utils, Avro, or whatever. So, yeah, we created our first streaming application. I'll do it like make it some bigger. Yeah, and on that stream, we want to do something. So what we just did from the REST service, we sent a transaction to a topic called payments. And now we want to have those payments. So we want to do something with it. So this is a different application. So your REST service is very quick now. And afterwards or instantly, you're going to do some other things like a balance check. And afterwards you can say somewhere just if it's okay or not. And then it continues or yeah. So what we can do is we can peek it. And what peek does is like it's doing we have a payment case stream here and it's doing, is that correct? Yeah. What is more handy is just showing me some text. So it's saying, hey, we are picking up something like checking the balance. And then the next step, we want to check some. I didn't sort it. So it is a little bit picky, tricky. Make something. Dot filter. Within that filter, you can do certain stuff. You can filter the balance and the amount. So what you can do is the same like here. You can do something like keep payments. And then again, this. And you can check the payment. Like we want to have the payment, the balance. We want to have it, it needs to be more than the amount, right? So I get balance. Oh, it's an. Oh, it's a float. It's already giving the balance. So it's giving a float and we want to check it with if it's bigger than the amount. So you can say, hey, payment.get amount and that's it. So now we created also a filter. So we want to check, hey, is this correct like this? I also want to open something else just to check it. So drop it here. Perfect. What we now want to have, we want to do something else. Did I forget something? Yeah. So the next thing is that we want to do something else, like we don't want to filter. Better make it like this, it's nice, all right? Yeah. The dot filter, yeah. More like a functional. Perfect. And what you can also do is to map it to a different object. So you can say, for example, map values. Let's do that. So we can say, for example, values, like we have the key and the payment. We have still some minutes. We want to create a fraud object because we will also want to check the frauds. What we afterwards want is we want to peek it here. So strange that it doesn't take it. It's annoying. So we have your stream. We have peaked it, so we want to check the balance. It's just some, you can check it if you want. It's sort, you can do a system outprint line or log, of course, right? It's giving you a case stream again. You can filter about it. Only get me messages which have a more balance than amount. We are going to map it to a new fraud object. We want to peak it. Again, we want to see, hey, the balance is okay. And next check is the fraud. So, yeah, we did this all. We will just want to return it. So what we are going to do is just return this. The builds. Oh, that's return. Oh, that's not possible like this. We just want to return the payment case stream, and that's allowed. It's expecting a stream, and this is not giving a stream, but it's a void. So we now created our first streaming application. So how nice is that, right? Yeah, we also want to check the fraud, like here. Like we want, after the balance, we want to check if there's a fraud, right? So what we are going to do is, again, we create the fraud stream of a peek it, with, which is again the same. It's builder.stream, and they give a topic name, and the topic is then fraud. So again, we have a fraud stream, and we peaked it. So again, we are checking the fraud. The next step is then check the again, let's do it like this. Sorry for the formatting. And then again, we can just say, hey, filter. And we can better maybe do it like this. And we have the filter. We want to filter the IBAN. Like we want to filter, like it's if it's a fraud. For example, we have an IBAN, it's like this, and this is a fraud. So we need to get that thing. Like it's a kind of blacklisting application. So we check all the IBAN numbers or something else if you want, right? And it's just checking if the IBAN is the same. The next thing is then we want to map the values. So we want to map the values. Like we want to map it to a new fraud object again. We want to just, what do we want to more? We want also have a peak moment and a split. So again, we want to see if we have a fraud, and then we are going to log it. That's the most important thing to do. Logging and creating metrics. Of course, you can create a counter. I don't know if I have the time yet, but otherwise I will refer you to another talk for me. You can also watch it. We also want to have a split. Like sometimes, if it's a fraud, we want to have a blacklist. And if it's not, if it's something else, like another one, yeah, this is a fraud, so that's not possible maybe. But yeah, you can maybe do some analytics. Like if you have a fraud, like here now, you want to have analytics. So I placed here reward. But you can better make it like analytics. So you're going to, yeah, it's just an empty method returning false. But yeah, you can check if you want that or not. And you can then going to forward it to another thing like calling analytics. So you want to watch those messages. Or you go to the default branch and we will send it to a blacklist. So we splitted the stream. So you can see it like a kind of blackjack. It's not gambling here, but yeah, you can split it in one branch on another based on a predicate. So, and we're going to return it. 5 more minutes, so perfectly. So we have a fraud stream. And here we're returning it. So what we did here, we now created more or less two applications in one topology. Mostly you have your one topology where you do certain things. Like fraud can be something that is handled by another team in your organization, because fraud and payments and that kind of things are mostly different organizations or different tribes or areas, or how you want to call it. But I created just in one topology, but you can see how it's working. So we created something. We missed a dot comma. Okay, well. And we created an integration test. We are going to test it. Let's test it if it's working. It's seeing, hey, balance okay, balance okay, balance okay. Oh, of course, it's not working because I didn't start the application. You can see it's hanging here, and then it's hanging for 10 seconds, and then you got a failure. It's the stress. So what we are going to do is just run the topology. Is it running correctly? Here you can see it's joining the groups. So it's already processing, see here? So it was checking the balance, and the balance was okay. And then it was going to my next node, or my next application, how we want to see it. It's just the bin in my application, just one. And you got the process, you got the fraud, and we don't want to process. So what you see now, because I already consuming messages earlier, so it was beginning from zero. So I already produced some messages, and it's already processing. And it's saying, got a fraud, don't process it, stop it. And then what it's doing, it's going to consume it to the default blacklist. And then other applications can consume from it, or multiple, that's very powerful. I did it with one message, but in a streaming way, you have big data and payments. You can imagine you will have millions or billions of transactions. So you can see, that is very mandatory to have something very quick. That's the most important. I'm going to try to run it. It will. Let's try it. And if it fails, you already seen it, that it worked. Yeah, so thank God. So it worked. So now I've shown you a normal way to consume and produce. And I've shown you to create a topology streaming application. How nice is that, right? Back to reality. What I wanted to show, but I was already afraid for it because of the time, I want to show you everything. You can also create metrics. Metrics is something you should do, and I will recommend this. This talk, it's also for me, but it's talking about how you should monitor your streaming application, right? You can log it, but in a streaming way, it will cost you a lot of memory because of the logging. And mostly you need trace IDs, you need to check it with which customer and IDs, and that is horrible. So you should create metrics in a streaming way. So my key takeaways, I've shown you how to create a cluster. It can be local, what I've shown you, but you can also do it in the cloud with a Confluent or Excel vendor. Very powerful. Don't manage it yourself. If you do it in production, it can be hard. You can also do it, of course, but then you maintain it. You need to create the topics yourself. You need to register your objects, your RFOs, and that kind of things. And I now did it myself, so I created my own RFOs and that kind of thing. So I shown you the consumer and producer with Kafka template and listening with the consumer. And I shown you the streams application with the use of Kafka streams. And now it's time. I want to thank you for your time. Please watch my GitHub. I will commit in a few seconds. It's already there, the slides. Please go there. Please follow me on Twitter and follow you back. Give some nice feedback, or if you think something can be better, also let me know so I can improve. So thank you very much. And back to you, André.